nice so far. I love working out here when it's nice. When it's rainy, you think it'd be fun out here, but it's really not. It's like having that garage door open. I think it's so much nicer. So, where are we at? Last time we tore that down. In the meantime, heads are off at the machine shop. And I got my ring filer. Parts are trickling in. I got the LS2 lifter trays. They're supposed to be stronger design than the ones I have. We'll compare those though. But the lifters, the LS7 spec lifters, are on back order, so that's probably gonna be the one thing that holds us up. Just a basic heavy duty LS2 timing set, gears, cam gear, Melling oil pump. I think they call this the high pressure standard volume one. I'm gonna give this ring compressor a try out since it was not very much money and it had good reviews on Amazon, so we'll give that a try. And then I kind of put together my own battery relocation kit, starting off with an ICT mount. So that's pretty slick. Big old fatty wire. I think it's like 20 feet of it. Smells like a tire shop. Smells good. You know it's good wire when it smells good. Power disconnect switch. But I am not gonna put this. I'm not going race car and I'm not putting this right there. Oh wait, that should look pretty badass, wouldn't it? Gosh, that would look good. No, I can't do it. I can't drill through the back right there. No. This thing's bulky and massive. If there was enough room behind there, I could, but it's not enough, so. Anyways, we'll figure out a way for this. I'm not making a race car. I just want a disconnect switch for, I don't know, security maybe? And ease of, I don't know, working on stuff. I don't know. I just figured since I'm redoing the battery cable, I'm gonna might as well just get one of these while I'm at it. And then a breaker. I didn't think 100 was enough, 100 amp, and I thought 200 was gonna be too much for how little stuff I have in here. So I went with 150. We'll see how this does. Maybe 150 will be fine. So anyways, head gaskets. The LS9 Brian Tulia head gaskets are on their way. Camshaft will be here Friday. ARP head studs will be here in a week or so. Everything's just kind of trickling in and everything's taking longer because of this whole thing. So I guess we can just start gapping these rings. Never done it before. Let's do it. Yeah, there's always that little bit of coolant still left in your block. But, yeah, it's messy. Well, I'm super happy with how clean this is. So what I'm gonna do is just do one piston at a time. Pop it out, file the rings, clean the top of the piston so I know that it's one that's done, and then work my way through. It's the very first rod cap. Yeah, I'm cool with that. Let's just remember that all these have a little circle that point towards the front of the motor. I don't know if I can do this with one hand. I can't get this with one hand. I'll be right back. Dot for the top ring. Bottom ring. Okay, so you're about to find out, this is basically the equivalent of a junkyard motor. Are these rings gapped good enough to run straight out of the junkyard? I don't know, let's see. That is a 0.0025. Let me find something better. Okay guys, without touching this, this is a 0.032. And that's where it's at. So I'm thinking that's fine. Let's check the other one. Okay, top ring is a little bit different. Top ring is right at 0.025. So we're gonna open that a little bit. We wanna be 0.028 to 0.030. That's what we wanna be. So this one will get filed. Check out my filing station. I have no idea how many times this is gonna take, so I'm gonna just do baby steps until I get there, until I get a feel for how much this takes off. So I'm just gonna grind like you just saw until I get it perfect, and then I'll let you know how much about how it took. I'm gonna show you guys how easy it is to get the piston inside there. Forgot to put some assembly lube on this. check these out and get these on Amazon. You just pick the bore size. $20. I've done all these pistons and there's not even a scratch mark in this thing. And it's just tapered. Works awesome. All done. All these are gapped. And then come over here. And oh, there's a piston missing. Because I'm a moron. And I broke a ring. And that one ring cost me $80. Because that's how much it's costing me to buy a whole new set of rings for one ring. So yeah, I gotta wait for that ring to get in here. It'll be tomorrow and I'll just put it together. But then I can start taking this stuff off and doing the oil pump, the cam, and the timing set. And then I can put that back together. But I think this will start going together pretty fast. I cannot end there because that was not the purpose of what I wanted to show you. So we were talking about earlier how can you pull a junkyard motor or something out and gap the rings? Is it safe to not gap the rings? What I found on this motor was that the rings just happened to be consistently gapped at 030 on the bottom rings and 025 on the top rings. So I left the bottom rings alone and I opened up all the top rings between 28 and 30. So this motor probably would have been fine with boost, not like 20 something plus pounds, but I think this would have been good for anything under 20. It probably would have been good for a long time, but I guess it's always good to check. I feel better now knowing that the rings are where they should be and there's not going to be an issue, but yeah, there's a good chance maybe if you pull your motor from the junkyard, it'll already have rings that are decent, but don't hold me to that. Check them yourself.